Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we would like to share with you about Istio for the containerized cloud foundry, some of our experiments, and also show you a demo later. My name is Xuexiang. My colleague Zhang Gong Grace, we are from IBM, Beijing, from the Beijing Development Laboratory. We have been engaged in the cloud development work and plus platform work, and also Bosch related tools, and it's a purely open source tool. And also the containerized is some of our work. Have you heard about CF or used it or called Cloud Foundry CF? This is the open source meetup, and we would like to give you a brief introduction of Cloud Foundry. This is the agenda. As a beginning, we introduce the project background and also brief introduction of Istio, and then motivations for the CFEE and the Istio integration. Grace will give you a presentation about the work we have done, including experience, drive, and the lessons learned, and also the future vision. The last part is about the demo and the use cases. This is a brief introduction of Cloud Foundry. It's a typical PaaS platform. It's the platform with the applications and the deployment of it to the platform for running. So the highlight is it can use a CF code from the soft code catalog to run the application to the platform, so you don't need the compiling and the packaging. At IBM, Cloud Foundry was established in 2013, and IBM Cloud in 2014 had their first public PaaS platform. It's on large scale. Now on the platform, there are more than 1,000 AMs. And also based on Cloud Foundry, we have the small and medium-sized companies and individual enterprises for dedicated platforms. For example, the 10 VM level to employee PaaS for isolation and the running of application. This is the introduction of the workflow. From this chart, you can see for a PaaS platform, it has a complex container. It doesn't, or it's not in line with the basic microservice. Each component has different drops, and each of the drops have its functions. So it's different from microservice. When a request comes in from the left ingress, and then it will seek for ABS for recording or logging. And then the auctioneer, this is scheduled. The scheduling makes it possible to find the appropriate container at the back end for deployment or staging or compiling. This is the garden, it's a specific container. For each PaaS platform, it has different cells. Each cell capacity is different. Some of them may already have been fully used, so they seek for the low workflow for deployment, and then the binary and the package will be stored at the droplets. So for the preparation or for the future use, you do not need to go through the compare. You can use this one for scaling. This is for the routely registration and the log collection through log gator to collect and through traffic controller. You can have exporter to receive the log. In 2014, actually, in the past several years, we are based on this platform. And since the year before last year, we hope that the Cloud Foundry is not deployed as a platform, instead as a service. In the past 50 or 60 VMs in such a big environment, the customer or client cannot make a deployment on their own. It requires the in-house team to deploy it. We want to migrate it to Kubernetes so that the clients can use our portal for deployment. In this way, it's a one-button deployment. You just choose the basic data centers and also select the size, for example, the number of debug cells. With the selection, then only one button, you can make the deployment 2 to 3 hours. Kubernetes cluster, and then on the cluster, you can deploy the containerized DCM. So the process is only about 2 to 3 hours. In the past, it took several days. These are some of the core features. It's isolated. The client has the Kubernetes individually, and we also enhance it. It can use the private services, including the communication, also our DB connection for ACE. Three ASAM protocol storage. They can use a private connection, and the users can manage them on their own. Doesn't need operations protocol. The operation team doesn't need to get involved in. This is an introduction for Istio. Swiss Match in recent years has become a hot topic. The important component is the pilot. Pilot is for traffic pilot route to have the high granularity control. There are many practices, for example, retry, timeout, or circuit. When there is an attack against the component, you can have the circuit breaking. For maintenance, it's also very helpful. For example, for upgrading, it can provide AB upgrading, canary upgrade. Based on your data center capacity, it can provide different functions. If capacity is large, then you can have a double size for AB upgrading. So the ATRIC can be a cut or switch over. If the it's not double size, then you can have a 10% of traffic moved to the new one and for gradual running. So it depends on the specific needs. The from green, the traffic management and the security, these are the major highlights. Security, here you can see the component. It provides a serve. Management and certificate generation. If you do not provide CAs, then it's it can help you to release their certificates and for deployment from. For the components, you can go through TTP. For the proxy, it can distribute the serves and add the mutual TILs. For external service, you find its external service out of the service wise, then it doesn't go through the mutual TILs. In this case, it has the security mechanism to protect the mutual TLLs distribution. This is about the motivations for a containerized CF with Istio. Actually, traditionally, VM-based Cloud Foundry, in fact, we had an in-house back-end team to do it.
Either for deployment or solving problems, basically, There is a manual control.
However,
when the self platform turns into a service, the customers, they can deploy many instant services, so it's impossible to allocate individual operators. So we want to help our users to achieve self-management. So this is one of the motivations. We found that Istio provides us with some capabilities like traffic management or recover the failure fault or canary or AB, which help to reduce the burden of our teams so that our customers can self-manage and self-upgrade. So this is main motivation we have. So these are the works for the experimental stage and tools that we used. We used Jaeger for open tracing and monitoring and Grafana. Canary and Visual are all for displaying the data using images so that we can see the problem very clearly. Like at what stage the traffic volume is high, or at what stage there are some inventories or job files. In fact, here are some summaries for functions that we used. And metrics logging tracing are also very important. In terms of open tracing, we had some pilot projects based on Jaeger or other projects, other products. We need some introduce some codes, not only rely on the Envoy or Istio to organize the trace, because we need header to deliver the code from upstream to downstream. We need code intervention, and it is kind of complicated. There is O-routine for job distribution and also using subscribe for delivering jobs. Later, we don't have much time to deliver research on this, so we want to focus on the contacts or header and turn them or connect them together from receive the request and then deliver to next header. Probably we can connect them to present a good trace map. Then when problems occur, we know where it fails or to see the exact time. In the past, it's about milliseconds, but it takes a few seconds to solve the problem, so the job queue might be found. So in terms of VM fail, we found similar problems. Some services encounter the networking issues, so the job queues are waiting for the problems to be solved. Since it cannot be finished in the short term, so the job queue fell afterwards. So by using open tracing, we want to solve these kind of problems. In external service, we mainly use it for DB. Some persistence can be recorded in remote DB. The drop pair will be recorded and the protocol. So for these two, we want to monitor it to see if the network works well. For the query DB, whether the speed is proper, whether the service is stable. Certificates, well, it is related to platform. So in fact, some good certificates has been managed quite well. By using Istio, we can see if we can do some search rotate to it automatically. Otherwise, one might need to do the search rotate every 3 months. We want to take Istio to make it work automatically. And now I will give the floor to Zhang Gong. Good afternoon, I'm Zhang Gong. Thank you. Matt talked about the PaaS platform and containerized function and why we use Istio and CFEE for integration. So we want to see how Istio can bring us with some new values. I want to see when we start to use Istio, how we solve the problems. When we work with CF operators team, how we learn from their experience and use Istio to solve the CFEE's operating scenarios. So if you know about Istio, on the official website there is a book info based on microservice. There are four microservices. In reality, not all the services are based on this. So CFEE is based on the traditional CF and containerized. Inside CFEE, not all the services are microservice designed, and not all of them are cloud native. In the past, in a VM-based platform, it's service for service. In the past, we used the resource of VMware, and there's a decoupling function being applied. After containerized, for the first step, one Kubernetes deployment can be mapped to several servers. But Istio take one deployment to one Kubernetes server. Then, in order to maximize the Istio's performance, on the official website, you can see some principles like we want to set the pod for service and understand the protocol for each pod and take the and name it in accordance with the protocol. If we want to define the deployment, like adding some labels, then for distributing the traffic or tracing, can be smoothly applied afterwards. In CFEE, we also redefined it. Another question is that inside CF, you can see that CF itself is very complicated and is a very large PaaS platform. It has many complicated traffic flow and based on previous designs, for example, in internal service, theoretically, Kubernetes should use a or QNS to assess those services. However, due to the historical design, some of them will go through externally and then the load balancer and then inside service. And there is some reliance on the external service which use different protocols. At version 1.0, we spent a lot of efforts because it is defaulted that the traffic will be used externally, and we feedback to the containers. For the version 1.1, the function was slightly changed so that you can better enable different services. At the same time, inside CFEE, as what we just said, there is a ongoing isolated CF design to smooth the traffic flow. Another is CFEE service is based on IBM Kubernetes platform. Many of the functions are relying on their features. One example here, IKSLB is a tailored, expanded Kubernetes. We used to rely on its features. Inside Istio, there is a gateway. Many of the functions are overlapping. So when we start to use Istio, we need to decide if some functions might be abandoned. So there is an ingress chain. So go through the ALB to the Istio. Some services will face with similar case. There could be a gateway so that you might need to decide whether to use it or not on a Kubernetes platform. There are some tools to manage it. And probably it's overlapping with the certificates management, so we need to decide it to use or not. About tracing, Istio provides us with many good features, which is no intrusions for those apps. But in terms of trace, we will talk more later on. I talked about some problems we ran into before, and these are our future vision. So, CFEE is based on a containerized and open source platform, and it is managed by us and IBM. The best practice or enablement are making contribution to the community. And CFEE is trying to make improvements. As what we said, it is not cloud native design. For example, like the deployment here is using Helm charge to manage the whole CF. So the community is trying to improve and using the operator of Kubernetes to deploy. The operator itself also have the ability to operate during the upgradation. They will wait for the V2 version to get ready and then delete the V1 version. Version 1. So such capability and the Istio's capability will be further integrated. The second direction is the Urini project. That's what we just presented to you about the platform CF. By using its control board, we can deploy it on the Kubernetes platform. We can also deploy on the containers platform and VMware platform. And this Urini is being incubating by the platform. And it is based on cloud-native design. So inside the Urini, we want to enable Istio so that Istio can further serve the Urini. Another direction is about the Istio mesh expansion. It's a new feature. Simply put, the control board of the Istio is deployed on the Kubernetes, so we can use it to manage the VM. In terms of the value to CF, by the communities of CF have users who are VM-based, so the experience or the best practice that we got can be reapplied on the VM-based CF. And then about during the integration, we were discussing with the operators to sum up the pain points and how to use Istio to solve those problems. First of all, as an operator or manager, during the operation, they might want to know during the operation of CFEE, how's the condition? And here you can see, so four of them, Istio think that these tools are being already embedded inside it after installation, which includes Jabber, Prometheus, Grunifon, and Visero is another visual tool which can help you for tailored service so that you can see the condition of whole service mesh. And I'm going to present you an example.
Okay, sure, we'll talk about
So first, I want to know how's the condition of the service mesh. This is the tailored traffic inside a service mesh. And you can see the service on CV and all the traffic. So the blue points are traffic. Many traffic are going to the service.
You can locate it onto the hotspot service, and for the key only, you can see the details, for example, the specific protocols. On the right side, you can see the requests and the responses results. When the service mesh, here you can see it can give you intuitive image of the failed requests, and also you can see the specific details of the request. For the visceral, it's based on the Prometheus data. The previous interfaces can be tailor-made. But if we want to have the further detailed troubleshooting, then we need more detailed data. That is the data of overall status. Now, for the Istio, how can we get the metrics and the logging and the tracing data from Istios, from the tracing from the VM at the base layer and the Kubernetes? You can use the platform capabilities to get the monitoring, logging data, and to the upper level, the components and the traditional CF also has the component metrics and logging data. Istio can provide the upper level data, including among the different services, and it's ready for use. It fills up the tracing gap. This is another demo. This demo is about metrics and the tricks. Here we take a look at the installation by default. You can see the preset metrics, and these are all the requests and the total of requests. You can see from which service to which service and the response code of each request. You can get all the information. This is a preset, but to help you with the real problem, you can customize the metrics, for example, the instance, or which features or which properties you should capture, and this is the customized sequence request. We want to capture the capture the service from and to, and you can have the methods and other attributes. For example, among the service, you have the key root path. You can also define it. This is the trees for troubleshooting. This is CF process. This is a push up process. In the past, SIE team took the CFEE architecture, but you may feel confused. But with the Istio's integration, you can open the canary directly. You can clearly see the option near service failure, and then we can further open Yeager to find out the service and the previous hour. Here you see precisely the trace of failure. You open it, then we get the details. This trace is captured when we send HTTP request to create a new task. When we push for a new task creation, has the error returned. Back to the slides, I mentioned another issue, that is the trace enable. On the left side, the trace is from Istio's official website. That is the example I showed you just now. You can see clearly when the user sends a request to the final response, the Spaun is the call, is the calling, and for each step that, of duration, we can help you to locate and define the problem. And the trace, you get by default Spaun, the request goes through MY. If there is no response, then you can have a root Spaun. But within the service, if a service is complex, you want to create a functional level trace, then you need to, in the app, get the information to build the Spaun. And when you call next service, all the trace headers must be sent to the next service. Another use case is about the elasticity or the resilience. We can use Istio capacity or principle of the circuit breaking. The circuit breaking means that when the service becomes very slow, the calling of services retrying, then it may cause a failure of the whole chain. So it may cause the very bad experience. So the circuit breaking principle is that when you set up the circuit breaker, when it's triggered and when many requests come in, it can go back to the 503 error. I will show you a demo. We use the client and API service to create 10 connections to send 2,000 requests. Now you see, without any operation, the API returns 100% or 200% of normal return. And then we build the circuit breaker on the canary. You can see the symbol or the mark, and you can see the configuration in details. The maximum TCP maximum is 5. Each connection has 5 as a maximum. And the pending request is 1 as a max or at max. Now I show you the results. I use the same traffic for access API server. So you can see it's triggered now. It's 99% request success. We enhance the concurrency. Now it's 20. We can forecast. We can get fewer than 200 return. So we enhance connection or increase the action to 50, then 30% of requests have the 200 returned. The use case is that in the traditional CF platform, we had the critical impact problems. For example, one client has the massive creation of users. When all the users access the API to get the information is very slow, so we use Istio circuit breaking to protect the API server, to give it some time for repair or for recovery. This is another use case. We want use Istio capacity to support CFEE upgrading. After the deployment, the process of upgrading must make sure HA is normal. After deployment of CFEE, we should make sure the application deployed is accessible and the service, the application can still be deployed. Based on Kubernetes rolling update, but you know Every time you only roll out one pod, Kube can support the deployment and the canary deployment. However, it has some dependency. You need to keep correcting the label, and the deployment has a dependency on the number of the base layers for traffic control. So we want to use Istio to have a simple and intuitive upgrading, also some fine-grained management. This is the demo of Istio for API service upgrading. Firstly, I show you the API deployment, the only version. This isn't the only version from Kali. You see the traffic 100% distributed to API's only version. So we deploy V2 at the beginning, only API group V1, and now V2. For the Kali, the V2 version is deployed. I do not need any deployment resource. Kubernetes from the service top for pod is a rolling out. So from V1 to V2, the traffic is 50 to 55%. We use Istio for canary rollout. We define the destination rule. That is the concept of destiny. It's about access to the backend upstream, and also we define Istio virtual service. The virtual service means that you get the request and traffic how to do a further routing. After the definition from the Kali, also we see intuitively two versions. Each version in, for example, has a V2, 10% of traffic distribution, V1, 90% of traffic distribution, so we can run some tests. The production traffic can have 10% to V2 full test. When the test is passed, we can roll it out. We can have a self-customized visual service. When all these pass the test, then we can upgrade to V2. With an Istio virtual service, zero downtime to distribute traffic to V2 version. This is the upgraded demo. Okay, that's all from us. We are already running out of time. If you have any question, you can come to us later. Thank you.